Now, this night was not unlike most nights in the drummer boy's village. The climate where he lived did not offer much in the way of seasons. So endless days passed into nights without much more than the phases of the moon to mark the passing of months and years. Perhaps this night was a little cooler than others, but not much. There was one difference, though. The star. It was the topic on everyone's lips, and the subject of much heated debate as to what it meant. It began growing out of the darkness only a few days earlier, and each evening it became brighter and brighter. Some even feared it marked the end of the world. Like always, the drummer boy's mother had sent him down to the river to draw water for his brothers and sisters to wash up before bed. He hated fetching water, mainly because the pail was awkward to carry with his drum slung over his shoulder, and he never went anywhere without his drum. As he stood by the river's edge, dreading the chore of carrying the full pail back through the village to his home, he was taken by the stillness of the water and the brightness of the new star's reflection upon it. He became momentarily transfixed by the tranquil beauty of the eerie light. It was at that moment that he overheard the conversation of several villagers hurrying by along the trail that paralleled the water's edge. They were going to see a royal baby born in the village. The drummer boy was suddenly filled with astonishment and wonder. He had never seen a royal before. He had only heard of such things. What splendor must there be to behold? Without further consideration, he left his pail just beneath the water, marking its location with a few distinguishable stones, and joined the small procession. As he walked along, he heard some speak of gifts, and he noticed that all seemed to be carrying something to offer the new king, but he was too excited to give it much additional thought. Halfway through the village, en route to the royal birthplace, he came within shouting distance of his own home, but he was too swept up in the events of the moment to risk going home and trying to make his mother understand. He stayed with the procession, which by now had been joined by others, becoming quite a little parade. At last, they rounded the corner of a large stone building at the opposite end of the village and poured out onto a small fenced clearing with a little stable at its opposite end. The stable, made of sticks and clay and covered with a thatch and palm roof, was surrounded by several farm animals. Some shepherds from the nearby pastures were also there, standing in the doorway of the stable. There was a warm glow of soft, flickering light emanating from a small fire inside. At first, the drummer boy thought this must be just a stop along the way to the royal birthplace, but he was puzzled as to why everyone would stop here. As he began to walk slowly toward the stable, he could not help but notice the star. It seemed to hover directly over the little stable, now shining so brightly that he felt he could almost reach out and touch it. Its light rained down in a gentle shower of soft hues that made the little stable and all those around it shimmer in a way the drummer boy had never seen before. As he came nearer, he noticed that those closest to the stable were kneeling, some on one knee, some on both. This he appreciated because it enabled him to peer over their shoulders and catch glimpses of what they were seeing inside.